With more than 20 years in the mental health field, Yana Mayotte has served in a wide range of behavioral health, direct practice, and executive leadership roles. From clinical therapist to chief clinical officer, she has worked with a diverse range of clients in school counseling, government, nonprofits, and psychiatric hospital settings. Her areas of primary interest are couples, work anxiety, trauma and attachment, issues of self-esteem, and culturally relevant clinical interventions. I'm telling y'all, better listen to this conversation. You better tag a friend right now. Share this on your page if you haven't right now. This is one of the most important conversations we need to be having in a time like this. And I guarantee you, when you cut on the news, you cut on the media, all the stuff you watching and you ingesting, this is not the conversation that they're having. Some of her official titles include wife, mom, psychotherapist, speaker, and CEO. Iyana is passionate about inspiring and challenging people to acknowledge and own all of who they are. Out of this passion, the launch of Perspective Counseling and Therapy was born. Leaders in culturally competent counseling, Perspective is a technology company whose mission is to prioritize African-American community by providing 100% online, culturally competent professional counseling in all 50 states via text, audio, or video, anytime, from anywhere. She believes that the African-American community has a right to get support, knowing that they will truly be seen and heard. How many of you guys have known that you needed help, known you needed counseling, needed therapy, but you felt like this other person, just from a cultural standpoint, just doesn't get me? Well, that's what we're talking about today, and that is my guest I'm bringing on. What's up, Miss Yana Mayotte? What's going on? How are you today, lady?
I am good. I'm listening to that, getting excited. I am good, and I am happy to be here. Thank you for having me.
No, thank you. Right. So as you know, I talked to Coach P and I talked to Lawrence, and then late in the day yesterday, I said, you know what? I said, people are facing so much trauma. And I don't know if that's the right word for it or not, but you can definitely let me know. I got the right person here. Right. And I just see it down in my stream. Right. And I see all the hurt. I see the pain. And a lot of this stuff, I feel like people either probably shouldn't be working on through on their own now, or in the future they're gonna need to get some help. Like, would you say that's accurate? If I'm wrong, totally tell me I'm wrong. Like, I'm just curious about what your thoughts are on it.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, people are struggling. We all are struggling in some way or another. The thing is that we all deal with exactly the word you use, the trauma, in different ways. And the thing about Black folks is that we don't even recognize a lot of times that what we're experiencing is trauma. It is little micro traumas, big traumas, aggressions, microaggressions, all these things happening, because it's just the way we've had to live for so long in a country that does not always lift us up in the way that we should be lifted up, and frankly is oftentimes against us. So we don't even recognize that we're struggling, that we're having a hard time. And definitely, folks, that's my purpose, my call. Folks got to be able to prioritize our mental and emotional health during all of this stuff that we got going on from day to day.
So how do they go about? So if they, you know, you talk about prioritizing their mental and emotional health, right? Like, what does that look like to somebody that's watching that says, like, right now, like, I was already stressed, right? And let's talk about that, right? The fact that like this is not out of a vacuum. People were already just going through regular life. Then COVID-19.
Yes.
You may be home. You may have been laid off. Your business may have been shut down and you can't work even though you want to work. Then the economy, right? And they're talking about, we may be heading into not just a great recession, but another great depression and joblessness and you fighting to go to the store every day, just get toilet paper and crap, right? Like, so we're dealing with all of this. And then on the heels of this, then it's civil unrest and it's uprising and it's, you know, fear for ourselves, fear for our children, for our young Black boys and young Black girls. Like what's the toll of that? Just compounding, you know, one after another in such a short amount of time.
Man, let me tell you something. The just as you went through and you just did that beautifully and kind of broke down all of these compartments in terms of how we are all experiencing the world as Black people, the pain, man, the pain is so deep. It is so multifaceted. It's so textured. There's so much stuff there that for real, I contend that most of us are not fully in touch with it. Like that is the essence of why I think folks really need to figure out how to take time to make space for themselves and their emotional and mental well-being, because we haven't even probably begun to scratch the surface for ourselves as individuals about how rough and deep the stuff is that we're dealing with. A, because of what I already said, we are used to it. You can become adjusted to dealing with trauma every day, just living in your neighborhood, just dealing with folks who are not for you, you working in a society that's not, for your own good, all of these kind of things, just regular everyday stuff, stresses, COVID-19, what have you. And then we always have to be bigger and better than other folks. And so it is so heavy that I think a lot of times we take for granted as Black folks that we are carrying stuff that really would make our knees buckle if we just took a little bit of time to even pay attention to what it is. And so I think what's important is that, you know, a lot of Black folks, and this is not all, because a lot of us are making a lot of progress with how we see therapy and how we see counseling. There's so many barriers, Lamar, so many things that get in the way historically for Black folks for good reason. There's a lot of mistrust, in terms of the healthcare system in general, mental health specifically. There's a lot of misdiagnosis that goes on, misdiagnosing Black folks, Black children. There's all kind of stuff, and there's a lack of cultural competence. So folks can't even resonate with you before they put you in a box and try to move you on out the door. So I think that Black folks have a lot of reasons to be kind of looking sad at, a little bit sometimes at this notion of unpacking their stuff. But the piece that I know to be true is, for example, that, I know one of the stats that always stands out to me and I tried to gather. It's like 2017, suicide was the second leading cause of death for Black folks ages 15 to 24. The second leading cause of death. But this is the kind of stuff we don't really talk about in terms of how people really be struggling and having a hard time, and we don't have places or spaces that we can go to, and we don't necessarily feel we have the permission to even do it. So it's a lot, it's already a lot. And I think that we normalize it because we've always been struggling and pressing through and making do with what we have. But we got to figure out how to be able to take care of ourselves in the midst of all of this at the same time.
All right, hold on. So we about to go, can we dig a little deep into this thing?
Yeah.
All right, y'all. Hope y'all don't look. I'm telling y'all, get somebody, tag a friend, share this on your pages. This is probably one of the most important conversations that you'll hear out of this whole thing, right? It's gonna be a lot of conversations going. It's probably one of the most important ones, and it's one we're not gonna hear enough of. So you just talked to, it was a lot you just unpacked from the historical lens and the view, right, of how we have viewed therapy, how we've been taken advantage of. There's mistrust, and there's reason. It's not all totally misplaced, right? Talked about misdiagnosis, which we hear often, which we see often, especially with our children. I don't even know if you hit on the religious aspect.
That's big.
Because a lot of people will think, that's just the devil playing games on you. That's just a trick, right? All you need is your Bible. And, that's something even when we did Black and Married with Kids, a lot of times we tell couples, like, y'all need to get some help. Like, this ain't, like, the way y'all, like, this ain't it. Like, y'all need to get help. And we'd have couples come and say, or somebody else weigh in and say, all I need is the Bible. All I need is the Word. They don't need to go talk to some man or some woman, right? Everything they need is in the Bible. And right. What I would say is that, like, when you break your arm, do you just say everything I need to repair my arm is in the Word, right? 2 Corinthians 4 and 18. No, man, you take your butt to a doctor. And perhaps if that's consistent with my faith is that God put people on this earth in place that know more than me about certain things, that can help heal me about certain things. Just like they can heal my body, is people on this earth that can actually heal my mind and heal some of the things I'm facing. I mean, how many times, I got so many questions for what you just talked about. Let's start with this one. How many times, specifically in our community, do you see that come in, or do you run into that religious, historical aspect of that being a barrier to people getting the help that they need?
You know what? If people have gotten a little more fancy with it now. So I will say that there's like a subset of Black folks who, they're in spaces and places where folks are like, you know what? Don't go over there talking to them. People trying to be fancy, trying to tell you something you already know. You can talk to your mama, your grandma, and come to church, and we can all figure this thing out. And that's that kind of old school thinking. And I think there are definitely subsets of folks and spaces that kind of still reinforce that, and not just reinforce that you can do it with God and God by yourself, but also reinforce that if you do that, somehow you're weak. Your faith is not strong. You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't have the right mindset. So we use all these code words that make us feel as though something about who we are on the inside is not strong enough. And the thing I always say is that it takes a real gangster to go to therapy. Like, you have to be strong. You have to have a different kind of internal character and groundedness to even show up, because going to therapy means you're about to open up some stuff and see some things that you perhaps have chosen not to see, have not wanted to pay attention to. But you know that if you do this thing, it's only going to be for your good. So it takes real strength to go to therapy. But this piece around weakness and around not having strong enough faith is a real big theme. I think the other thing too, Lamar, and I think this is the misunderstanding when it comes to therapy and counseling, is folks view the therapist, the counselor, as the person who has the information. They're going to give you some things. They're going to tell you some stuff. They're going to set you straight. And especially Black folks in our community, you know, we hold in high regard our elders, our spiritual leaders, folks who know some things, been around the way. And you don't necessarily have to have any degree or licenses behind your name. We just know that you know what you're talking about. And we hold that high. In our community, gaining counsel, going and seeking counsel, is culturally a part of what we do. It's like, well, you know, go talk to your granddad, or go over there and talk to your uncle. That's a part of what we do. We sit down and we talk about things. So it's not that we don't talk. It's just that we are very leery about who we talk to. And I think the thing that is the misunderstanding is that therapy is not a place. Yes, therapists have training and have some assets and things that you perhaps have not been exposed to. But therapy is no more than a person coming and saying, I'm going to slow down, I'm going to make space, I'm going to get in touch, and I'm going to access wisdom. But the wisdom that I'm accessing is my own. As a therapist, it's just my job to help you access what you already know. It's not that I'm giving you so much stuff, like, let me drop this on you. I might prompt you to that. But ultimately, everything that folks need is already in them, in our historical kind of memory and DNA, but also inside of us in terms of our own sense of self-determination and our ability to overcome. So I think a lot of times folks think like, oh, I'm going to go to this person who's going to psychoanalyze me and tell me about myself. The best culturally competent counselor is someone who's going to join with you, is going to help you unfold what you already have on the inside, not drop all of these things that, you know, you didn't have before you got there. That's just not what counseling and what therapy is all about. So I think that's an important thing to lift up.
I love it. And I just put up one of my one of the comments that came through. Thanks, Roz, for dropping that. She quoted you. It takes a real gangster to go to therapy. Somebody better put that in the chat. You better quote that. Make sure you tag Iyanna. This is the conversation that we need to be having right now. So you talked about a second ago the fact that, and I don't know if this is a cultural thing with us or people in general. I don't know, right? But I know it exists. I don't know what happened outside of us, but I know it exists with us, where mm-hmm. it's this toughness, and it's this armor that we put on that we have to be strong, right? Because like I said, we gotta be twice as good as somebody else in order to get the same level of recognition of people outside of this community. I gotta show up at work in a whole different way, right, than everybody else may have to show up in there, because people are viewing me through their perspective and through their lens in a different way. I gotta mm-hmm. sit up and drive a certain way when I see police officers on the side of the road. Like, all of this stuff, right, I think are things that probably contribute to us having to put this armor on and feeling like the armor is always there. But how do we get beyond that feeling of I have to be strong? Sometimes I'm not even sure if everybody even realizes that they have that armor on when it's on, until we have problems connecting with friends, until we have problems connecting with loved ones, until we have problems in our relationship, and we're like, we've built all these walls and silos around us. Like, how can somebody even, A, realize that they that may be an issue, and then B, begin to remove that armor, remove those walls of saying, I don't have to be strong all the time. I can be vulnerable, and I can't find a safe space.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I think that's a great question. And I think the biggest thing is, you know, reframing. What we talk about in therapy all the time is, how do you do a reframe? And the reframe, kind of going back to what I said a second ago, is you actually are strong when you actually can own all of who you are. You can own, you know, I am gangster. I am, you know, I'm a boss. I'm this, I'm that. I execute. And, you know, I kind of stumble when I'm in spaces where I got to be emotionally vulnerable, or I got to talk to my wife about this, or, you know, I have some social anxiety when I go around a bunch of new people and it feels weird. I don't feel like I'm a part of the space. And that seems to be a real theme in my life, right? Like, when you can own all of that, it's when I've seen people, Lamar, who, you know, show all of themselves, that I'm like, wow, I really admire this person, but they just like, they just themselves, and they don't hold back the parts of themselves that perhaps, you know, people would judge as not being on point. That I really, really feel blessed to be able to kind of witness them. And so I think that people have to, again, reframe and understand that there really is strength and being vulnerable. Therapy is about being vulnerable. And that piece right there can only happen if you pull from a strong place. You can't be vulnerable and you know, kind of go down to the, you have to be strong in order to be able to even kind of give that up for other folks. So it's about a reframe. But then the other piece, what was I gonna say? The other piece, Lamar, is that I lost my point. But I think the main piece that I want to really kind of push forward is this, and it's this right here. When it comes to really opening up and letting folks in and letting people see you, you can't allow for anybody else to do what you won't do with yourself. So to me, when you have the ability to create space for yourself, so that you can have a space. I mean, like you said, with all this going on right now, with everything that's happening, when you can create space for yourself, that is a revolutionary act. That is a radical act to say, like, nah, even though I have all of this other stuff, I have to make space for myself so that I can show up stronger, better, brighter for the things that are important to me. Many of us are entrepreneurs. Many of us, you know, are trying to leave legacies. We're trying to do major things, but we can only go as far as the insight that we have. And there's so much about ourselves that we don't know, we don't see, we don't recognize in terms of our emotional kind of state that we wouldn't even pay it. We just don't even know it's there. I mean, you just said that a second ago. We don't know that it's there. And so if we do a little time taking with therapy, it can allow us to actually be stronger and brighter in the places that we really do want to show up for, even though, because most folks don't want to go to therapy. You know, when you say you're unpacking some stuff, we know we need to go, or it might be helpful to go, but nobody's usually excited to go. Some folks are, because they get all into it. But I do think that it's something that, you know, folks just have to recognize it really is going to give you more in the areas that you value the most. You want to be a really good leader, you got to have really good personal insight. You know, if you want to be a really good partner or a model in the world, you really got to be emotionally intelligent, which means you got to be self-aware. You got to know how you're impacting other people and all that kind of stuff. Therapy, man. You know what I'm saying? Kind of know what your soft spots are and where you really do well. And so it's a mix of a lot of things, but I think that folks have to find the why for them, and that will help folks to be able to push forward and deal with some of the stuff that's there for them to deal with.
I love it. Hey guys, do me a favor. If you got questions for Yana, go ahead and drop them into the chat. I want to be able to kind of bring a few questions to her. If you guys got questions and things you kind of want to, you know, trying to figure out based on this conversation, drop them down to the chat. While we're waiting for those to come in, one of the things I normally ask around the time is like, you know, how can people get in touch? How can they get more help? But you actually are launching a new site through Perspective, right? Can we talk about that a little bit?
Yes, I would love to talk about that. So Perspective is the new platform that will be launching in beta mode this summer. And it is a 100% online counseling platform that you'll be able to access through your browser, through app. And we are focusing on the African-American community, and we are doing that unapologetically. And we are really, really aiming to be the leaders in culturally competent professional counseling and therapy. And so folks will be able to have their therapist in their pocket. Take out your smartphone or get your tablet or your computer, and you'll be able to, you know, access a therapist in all 50 states. It is a different model. The model is an unlimited counseling model. So every month you'll be able to have unlimited counseling, and you'll be able to access your therapist again through text messaging, through audio, through scheduling live sessions. But it will not be like waiting. I got to wait till next week and I got to wait till next week. It is that ongoing access that really makes it amenable to folks. And our commitment is to making sure that we increase the access to culturally competent counseling, and that we really like destroy the stigma that oftentimes is associated with therapy and counseling. So we're excited about that. And people can visit tryperspective.com to get more information. It's tryperspective.com to get more information and to sign up and stay connected for updates and things like that.
All right, guys. And that is the website you see on your screens right there in front of you, tribeperspective.com. I'll drop that into the chat. But if you want y'all to bring it up, drop into the chat as well, because we got a lot of different chats going on, a lot of different platforms between TSP and BMWK. This is a great conversation. I love it, right? And as we kind of talk about this, it's like I said, people need help, right? Like, people already need help in general, right? Just with their everyday, what they face. But right now, there are going to be so many people in our community that need to get this help. So I encourage you guys, there is access to resources. There are people that are culturally competent, like Yana said, that understand the lane that you're coming from, that understand the things that you're dealing with, and that are here to help you and assist you kind of work through it. You also had two things coming up. I said, this upcoming Tuesday, yeah, June 2nd, 8 p.m., you got a panel discussion?
Yeah, a panel discussion in the group. I would encourage and love for folks to join Therapy for Black Folks by Perspective here on Facebook. Join the group. And we have a panel discussion happening on this coming Tuesday, 8 p.m. with six brilliant, skilled Black therapists. And we're talking about therapy and Black folks, the myths, the truth, and everything in between. So that's this Tuesday, June the 2nd at 8 p.m. Eastern. And then more information, more details will be forthcoming. But next Sunday, which I believe is June the 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, I believe, June the 6th, next Sunday, we're going to be having a free virtual community support group, particularly in light of these times, for folks to come together. And more details will come out with regards to that. Folks can go to tribeperspective.com/events, and information will be there about that. That's on next Sunday.
All right, y'all. And we just dropped those into a few of our chats as well. If it wasn't, in yours, again, go to the website, tribeperspective.com. You can get a hold of everything and find everything. And then we also, in our chats, drop the link to the Facebook group as well, so you guys can join the Facebook group. Highly encourage you to do that and to get it started, right? We're getting the actual help and the perspective that you need. And y'all, just thank you for caring enough about the community, right? You and your husband, I said, you know, y'all are community-minded folks. So thank you for even caring enough about the community to launch this initiative and get it out there. I know, you had your sights set on the summer 2020, but things will probably get ramped up and sped up a little bit quicker than that, just because everything's going on because of the need. But I'm sure that you guys will step up and stand into that need and into the gap.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Lamar. I appreciate the opportunity. And of course, always, I appreciate you and everything that you do for Black folks, entrepreneurs everywhere. So thank you.
All right, thank you. Right. Any last words? Anything you want to leave the people with?
Go to therapy.
Peace. Here we go, y'all. Simple enough. All right, thank you. Have a great day.